Hormones. Everyone has them, but do you know just how powerful these molecules are? How they affect your entire existence as you know it? So let's talk about them. But let's put a slight twist on it. We're gonna focus on what happens when someone undergoes hormone therapy. This is commonly used for women going through menopause, but we're gonna look at hormone therapy used for transitioning genders. No matter what your gender, age, or race, everyone has both estrogen and testosterone in them. Estrogen and testosterone are the main components in the body that make a person look male or female. Now, what makes a person feel male or female? Well, that's an entirely different video. Okay, now in females, the ovaries and adrenal glands produce estrogen and testosterone. Testosterone in females is important for muscle strength, sex drive, and sense of well-being. Now men have about 10 times more testosterone than females, and males can produce testosterone in the testes much faster than females can in their ovaries. In men, testosterone is chemically converted to estrogen as the body needs it for maturing sperm and possibly regulating sex drive. So when a person transitions to the opposite gender, they undergo hormone therapy to adjust the levels of estrogen and testosterone in their body. This essentially puts a patient through a second puberty. While the new hormones can't totally reverse the effects of the first puberty, it's the development of the secondary sex characteristics which makes the person begin to physically appear as the gender they identify with. When males transition to females, they're also given antiandrogens. These block testosterone from doing what testosterone is supposed to do and lowers the amount of testosterone overall. The significant reduction of testosterone means the typical secondary sex characteristics in men will start to go away. Muscle mass will shrink, fat will redistribute, and body hair will become thinner and lighter. In order for female attributes to develop, transitioning males take forms of estrogen in gels, pills, or shots. Although hormone levels may reach targets in the first year of therapy, it takes roughly 2 to 3 years for the physical changes to occur. But hey, that's still quicker than puberty. Female transitioning to males are given testosterone, sometimes called T. That's the one. Alright, T can be applied topically with a gel or through routine shots. The increase of T lowers the voice, produces facial hair, and increases muscle mass. This increase of T also lowers the amount of estrogen in the body, causing the breasts to decrease in size, the shoulders and hips to broaden, and the menstrual cycle to stop. It takes about 1 to 2 years of being on these hormones for a born female to attain male levels of estrogen and testosterone. So, there you have it. Estrogen and testosterone through hormone therapy play a huge role in physically transitioning genders. And since these hormones are so powerful, you should never take hormones without talking to a doctor first. Alright, so there's our weekly dose of chemistry for you. Have a topic you'd like us to cover? Well, tell us about it. Comment down below or hit us up on Facebook or Twitter. While you're at it, hit that there subscribe button and be sure to share our videos with your friends or, you know, complete strangers, whomever. And hey, thanks for watching.